okay? So today for you, what I'm gonna do for you all is bake cheesecake.
I love cheesecake.
But I got three different flavors. We're gonna do Oreo, plain cheesecake, and red velvet. So stay tuned and see what comes next. All right, so first what we're gonna do, we're gonna take this Duncan Hines box cake. You can use any box cake, use your baked red velvet from scratch, or you could buy a cake somewhere, but what I wanna do is use the box cake, and we're gonna have this for our crust and little chunks of cheesecake inside. So we're gonna follow directions as is on the back of the container, and it says 3 large eggs, 1 cup of water, and 1/3 cup of vegetable oil. So I'm gonna add, boom, here go our oil. Great value, it's okay, you know, it's all the same. Okay, so once you add your 3 eggs and oil to your red velvet batter, what you're gonna also do is add a cup of water. Now, I have these little things here, so that's 1/3. 2/3, and if you did basic math in elementary school, 3/3, that's 1 cup. And I'm gonna blend these together. Try to keep it going in one direction. All right, so we have our spring foam pan here, you guys. Now, normally you could take some Crisco, you know, lard, whatever your grandparents use, and grease a pan. But for time's sake, we're gonna use wax paper on this spring foam pan. Put your cake in, so when you undo it, move around the wax paper, it just pops right out. So, it's about 9 inches. You get a large enough piece of the wax paper and put it inside of your pan. And you just get it in there so that it kind of, you know, sits cozy enough. It's gotta be washed. And then you just pour your batter for your red velvet into the pan. All right, and we're gonna get this to bake at 350 degrees. Make sure your oven has preheated for about 7 to 8 minutes at 350. And now we're about to put this red velvet baby inside the oven. And what we're gonna do, like I said, we're gonna follow the directions on the red velvet to a T. And it says that it should bake in the 9-inch pan for about 20, 25 minutes. And then by the time we're finished mixing the cheesecake, that should be ready to go. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna make the crust for the Oreo cheesecake. I have 6 Oreos here. If you have a food processor, please utilize it. We're gonna be ghetto today and use a blender. So just drop those in there, cover it politely, and all right, you guys. So for those of you who thought that this entire tutorial was gonna be out of a box, you're wrong. I make my cheesecake from scratch. So what we're gonna start off with is 4 packs of the 8-ounce Philadelphia cream cheese. And I had it out the container so they could start to kind of soften a little bit and not be so hard for when I start mixing it. And cheesecake is a very funny thing. You have to do it in a particular order. So we use sour cream, sugar, eggs, cream cheese, and a little bit of flour. But you don't want to put them all at one time. So what the first thing you want to do is cream your sugar in with your sour cream. And I'm going to put about 1.5 cups of sugar with this. So, let's see. And before you add anything else, what you want to do is cream this together so that it can start to have that smooth cheesecake consistency. So now what you want to do is add your vanilla for taste. I personally put about 1/4 cup of vanilla, maybe a little more, just because I like vanilla. So this gives that cheesecake the uncheesy taste. And then, one by one, you're gonna have 4 eggs. One by one. Okay? 2/3 at most of sour cream in here if you want it to be a little creamier. What I did, I just put maybe 1/3 of a spoon because it was already kind of creamy, and we just put 3 eggs instead of 4. Since we are making cupcakes, you know, it calls for a little bit more density than a whole cake would. We're gonna check on the red velvet, see how things are coming along in here. And look at that, it is coming somewhere. All right, so we're gonna let that go for about 10 more minutes. And while this cheesecake is just sitting here, what I'm gonna do is take my graham cracker that I grated and my Oreo that I grated and line the bottom of some of these cupcakes. Butter here, about 4 tablespoons, and what this butter is to do is just to keep all the crust together. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of this and put it onto each crust. All right, so now we're gonna see what this red velvet is looking like. Oh, that's pretty. Oh, that's beautiful. Look at that. Okay, y'all. Y'all, we gonna go ghetto again. Put the red velvet in the blender. So we're gonna fill up the cheesecake in each one of these. Now have your cheesecake or cupcake container as close to you as possible. So now we've finished filling up all of these cupcakes. Now, since we are at the pre-function, shout out to my org, we're gonna have some teal cupcakes and some red cupcakes. Whistle. So here we go. Now I'm gonna just put 1 drop of green here. Drop here. This is the blue. What I'm gonna do with this green and blue, excuse me, y'all. Take a fork. We're just gonna mix this up like this. Don't forget, Matt got more than 2 colors. So in order to accent all of this here, we're just gonna put a little bit of the red. Guys, so now with these mad cupcakes, I'm just gonna dress it up and make it real on the rest of cupcakes.
Dress it up and make it real for me.
Eskimo, the coolest DJ in the world.
Whatever that fucking means.
Okay, so we're just gonna put these in here and bake them for about 25 minutes, and then we'll check and see what we got. Alright, you guys, we'll try to pull these bad boys out of the oven. Let's see what this looks like here. Ooh, wee. Look at that. So now, we're gonna let these cool overnight, and we're gonna taste these boys and see what they taste like.
Sensational. And that's the word you're looking for.